Fine. So welcome to this demo session. And as you see the title here, it's going to be Release 12 Financials Online Training. We'll have all these course related discussions. I mean to say just understanding the product and doing some hands on and whatever.
Excuse me. The course curriculum. Hello. Lakshman?
Yeah, please.
Lakshman, this is Komal here. Lakshman, I'm unable to view your screen.
You can just disconnect and connect again. That may resolve that issue. Already I shared the screen. Hope everyone can see.
I'm actually not able to
see. Better you can just disconnect and connect again.
Yeah.
Fine.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay, the course duration would be around 120 hours, and here we are going to cover all the areas of understanding theoretically and system related configuration in the real time related how the project takes place and what you should learn exactly, how you have to attend the interviews, how to crack the interviews. Okay, so there are many points which we mentioned in the course curriculum. You can go through it anyway. I'll take you through the course curriculum also in the today's session. Okay, so as a part of today's demo agenda, like here, these are the points which we are going to discuss. First, we'll see what is the meaning of Oracle and how the Oracle is different from Oracle applications and what exactly Oracle Financials means. And here we'll understand what are the different applications will be part of our Oracle Financials. And when I talk about Oracle applications, we have a different applications which are grouped into different product families. We'll talk on that. The next point we'll discuss about what is the meaning of ERP, why we are calling the Oracle applications as a ERP product, and what are the different application versions are available in the market from Oracle Corporation. And the other point here is the prerequisites and what are the eligibilities to do this course for anyone. We'll talk on that. And what would be the role of functional consultant? It can be any functional consultant. We'll talk on that more detail level. And how the training will be conducted and what should be learning methodology when we are doing this course. We'll discuss on this. And finally, we'll talk about career opportunities on Oracle Financials. And the other point here I mentioned, the course curriculum. I'll take you through the detailed course curriculum. Hope everybody has received. The same I am going to take you through if you're not received by this time. Anyway, we'll be sending. You can just respond to our email, whatever link today you received, to that you can reply saying that you wouldn't get the course curriculum, so that we'll be able to share it. Okay, so these are the few points we are going to understand in the today demo session. Okay, so let's get into the actual discussion. The first point is, what is Oracle? So when you say Oracle, it got many, you can define it in the different way. One, you can say, so Oracle is nothing but simply database. In other words, you can say Oracle is one of the database company. Or else you can say Oracle is software vendor. Okay, so but purely when you say just Oracle, it means database. The Oracle, the company name is Oracle Corporation. Oracle Corporation came into the market with the database concept. Okay, database concept, later they developed the applications and entered into ERP. Those points we are going to discuss. But what is the Oracle? The meaning we have to understand. Oracle, when you say Oracle, simply it's nothing but database. Oracle is one of the database. We have many databases in the market. So out of that, Oracle is one of the database in the market. Fine. So when you say Oracle, it got some meaning. Okay, it stands for, so here you can see just the first point, just I mentioned here, it's a one of the leading database in the market. And it's the same like Oracle is one of the software company. You can say ERP also, but ERP, when you say ERP, we have to include the applications. That point we'll be discussing. So as of now, take this point as Oracle means database. Okay, so when you look at the Oracle, it says like the meaning of Oracle is Oak Ridge Automatic Computer Logical Engine. Okay, here you can see automatic computer logical engine. It's nothing but it defines the meaning of database, how database can be useful in the process. Automatically it can compute, okay, certain operations which you perform on the database by following certain logics. It works as an engine to store the data, retrieve, to perform any database related operations. Here ERPTREE means some whatever the laboratories initially they just used to just to design and develop this product, the name they just included as a ERPTREE. The rest of automatic computer logical engine, it defines the meaning of database. So Oracle stands for ERPTREE automatic computer logical engine. So it's a purely database. So when you look at the database consists of tables. Okay, within the database we can have a tables. What is the purpose of tables? Tables store the data. So yes, we have a database. Within the database you can find the tables. So how you want to store the data accordingly, you can keep the tables, you can create the tables, and you can store the data into tables if you want to. So by learning this course, we are not going to create any tables. Just we are trying to understand few points which will give us better understanding to know about what is the meaning of our Oracle applications and Oracle and other points. Just try to understand these few points, then we can get more clarity going forward. Fine. And you say database, so Oracle is a database. Within the database, we can have a tables. Within the tables, we can store the data. Fine. We have a database and we want to store the data into database. How to store the data into database? Okay, how to store the data into database? It's very simple. You can use some front-end tool. You can use some front-end tool, and whenever you use this front-end tool, so through this front-end tool you can write some commands or you can write some syntax. With the help of some front-end tools, you'll be able to store the data into database. If you just look at this picture like this, you can find as a database, and I want to store some, say, employee data into database. How to store? By using the certain command. So if you want to store the data in the database, what we have to do is, so there is to deal with any database, to interact. Now I'm interacting with you by using the language called as English. Okay, in the same way, if you want to interact with the database, if you want to interact with any database, you should know the language called as SQL. You should know one language called as SQL. Every database can understand the language called as SQL. Okay, SQL stands for Structured Query Language. Okay, structured query language. If you interact with the database by using the language called as SQL, the database can understand what just information you are trying to pass, what information you are requesting. So accordingly the database will respond, okay, based on the information which is available in the database. So if you want to interact with the data, any database, what we have to do is we have to use some front-end tools. Say for example, have a certain records of data I want to insert into database. If I want to insert into database, we require experts who knows SQL language. So we have to hire the guys who are expertized on the SQL. Say for example, you did some sales activity. The sales information we have to store in the sales tables. The sales information will be providing to the guy who can just write SQL statements. They'll just write the statements and they'll be inserting the data into database. When they're writing certain statements to insert the data into database, they have to follow certain exact syntax. They have to write commands very properly, and it would be very difficult task for anyone to write all the commands every time, and where system will do that validation, and if the information is very much proper and it is following certain guidelines of structures and formats, then only the data can be inserted to table, and only this job can be done by SQL experts. Okay, it's a very difficult task which we were doing in the very earlier stage. Okay, so the simple point here we have to understand is, to store the data into database, we have to use the language called as SQL. By using the SQL language, we can store the data into database. If you want to see the data which is there in the database also, by using the SQL language, we can call the data and we can see and we can understand. And if you want to do some changes, or if you want to delete, or if you want to modify anything, any operations you can perform on the data which is available in the database by using the language called as SQL. For that, we use some front-end tools. But just take this point, and going forward, just we can understand more detailed information. So it would be very challenging for anyone who are going to write the commands to store the data in the database. So for that reason, what Oracle did is, they developed forms. So they developed a form, say for example, here we have one form called as invoice form. Say for example, you purchase something, we have to make the payment to supplier. So what you purchased, okay, from whom you purchased, when we purchased, how much we have to pay, when we have to pay, all the details we have to maintain in our database. So if you want to maintain all the information in the database, you have to use any one of the front-end tool. Okay, within the tool, you have to write this kind of syntax in the SQL language. So that's how you can store the data into database. So as an alternative solution, okay, what Oracle did is, they developed forms. They developed Oracle forms. This is the one of the form which is developed by Oracle, which can be developed by anyone, okay, who are developers on the specific language. So Oracle developed one form, I mean forms they developed in this way. So what we can do is, now if you have a certain record which need to be stored in the database, now you don't need to go with any third part, any tool, and to write the syntax and to store the data in the database. What Oracle did is, they developed the form and they given all the fields of information, fields. So what data need to be stored in the database based on the activity or business process which you followed, and all the fields they given. Now, with this form, we can give it to anyone. Anyone can enter the data into this form who doesn't know SQL language. But before these forms, the person who is going to store the data in the database, they should know the language called as SQL. If they know the language called as SQL, then only they can store the data into database. If they don't know the language called as SQL, there is no option to store the data into database. But after developing the forms, so these forms can be given to any person in the organization. They can enter the data by seeing that the field name, or call it as a label name, and they can enter the data. Simply they can save it. Once the information is saved in this form, okay, that will go and sit in the database. That means what Oracle is doing is, this form they develop, this form they connected to database, and what are the fields we have here, accordingly they created tables within the database. So now user no need to write any statements. They no need to worry about the SQL language. By using the SQL language only, these forms are developed. Any user can enter the data within this form based on the information which they want to store in the database. Simply they can enter and they can save. The data will go and sit in the database. That's how the solution they simplified when you compare with the previous practice of writing the statements and storing the data into database. So these are the forms. So this is I have another slide to understand the same point. Here we'll be entering the data, the same entire form related fields information. Okay, but to support all the fields related information, we'll be having the tables within the Oracle database. User will enter the data here, they'll save it, that will just get stored in the Oracle database, any form. So all the forms will get connected to the database. That means we'll have a form, we'll enter the data, that will get stored in the database. Okay, so the combination of, okay, say here we are just taking example as one or two forms. In the same way, when you talk about any department, so each and every department will do certain activities which are related to specific business function. That means specific department related activities they do. If you talk about payables department, generally they'll just deal with the payments. They'll be processing the payments to vendors. Before that, they have to get the information from inventory department or vendor or from purchasing department, the supporting documents. When payables department is going to make the payment to supplier, they need some documents, the proof of purchase, say the voucher information. So they will have to, the payables department has to maintain the invoices information. So based on that invoices, within the invoice, they can have all the details our organization is purchased from, which is a supplier, when they purchase, how much we have to pay, what we purchase, all the details, when we have to make the payment, all the information we can have in the purchase invoice. Based on that, the payables department can make the payment. Along with that, all the suppliers information and all other details, the bank account details, all the information need to be maintained by payables department. That means when you take example of any one of the department will perform many activities. They'll be performing the different activities. To support those different activities, they have to maintain the different set of data. So one, if you take any one of the departments, say let's say payables department, if you take example of payables department has to process the invoice information, payment information. They have to maintain the bank account details to make the payments to the suppliers. They have to maintain the vendor information. To maintain the specific department related information, so we can have a different forms. To maintain the suppliers information, we can have one form. To maintain the invoice information, we can have a one form. And to maintain the, to process the payments, we can have a separate form. To maintain the bank accounts information, we can have a separate form. So these all information is required by payables department. So that means all this collection of forms simply you can call as application. Okay, group of forms. So for example, this is invoice form. This is payment form. This is supplier form. This is a bank account form. So these all set of records information need to be maintained by one specific department. So what are the specific, what are the activities will be performed by specific department? So all the activity related information you can have a forms, the group of forms which will be used by specific department, you can call as application. When you say application, definitely these are the forms, we will be having the forms. Each form will be connected with the database. So if you go to any one of the application, say for example payables application, that means the payables application will contain certain forms which will support payables related business process. You take this example only. Payables department has to process invoices, payments. They have to manage the suppliers information, bank accounts. This group of the form, these all four forms are going to be used by payables department. So this group of forms we can call as application. Which application? Payables application. So when you say any application, the forms will be connected with the database. And whenever you store the data in the database, the data would be available to generate the reports. Here we have to understand three points. We have to understand three points. When you say application, we'll have a forms, we'll have a database. What are the data we have within this database? To view the data or to report, we'll be able to generate the reports. The forms, database, reports, the combination of these three elements only we call as application. So how the application can be decided? For each department, we can have separate application. For payables, one application we can have. For receivables, we can have separate application. For purchasing department, we can have one application. For sales department, separate application. So based on the department related activities, we'll have a forms. The forms will help us to enter the data which can be stored in the database as a part of respective business function. Okay, so now we'll talk about finance or financials. When you talk about financials, what would be part of financials? As a finance department, okay, if you take look at any finance department, what activities they'll be performing within the finance department? Let's look into that information more detail level. Say these are the primary areas or primary functions where finance department will be handling. So primarily like this all comes under finance departments, okay, or else different functions you can treat. Normally let's say payables department. Okay, payables department, what payables department do? Any company, they'll make the payments. They'll be making the payments to suppliers. The purchasing department procures whatever organization required. Once purchasing department is done the purchasing activity, so the next step will be making the payment only based on the terms. There'll be the payment terms which says when we have to make the payment. By following that information, the payables department will have a responsibility of processing the payments to suppliers against the purchases. And the other department is receivables department. What receivables department do in the company? They receive the payment from customers. Cash receipt, nothing but customer payments. So sales department do the sales activity. Against the sale, the payment should be collected and received by receivables department. Sales department will do the sales activity. Receivables department will receive the payment from the customer. And asset department, they'll maintain the fixed assets. So what are the fixed assets organization will be having? Maybe owned or leased, whatever. Okay, So all the assets will be managed by asset department, say buildings, computers, land, furniture, vehicles, whatever the assets we have as a part of organization, all will be managed by asset department. They'll maintain the all the assets, and based on the usage and based on the other classification of assets, will be calculating the depreciation. The other department is cash department, or you may call as treasury department. So what cash department or treasury department do in the company? They'll maintain the cash. It's nothing but when you say cash, generally it's a bank accounts. So the cash department or treasury department will take care of the cash maintenance activities. They'll maintain the activities, they'll look after cash inflows, outflows, and bank statement reconciliations and all. Anyway, we are going to discuss more detail level in the next slide. And other department is general or common department. What common department will do, they'll be collecting the information from all other financial areas of the departments, and they'll be preparing the financial reports. So what are the payables department is doing, receivables department, asset department, treasury. So based on the reporting requirement, they'll be collecting the relevant information which is required, and based on that, they'll be preparing the reports. So these are the very key functions, or the key activities will be done by specific departments. So these all activities, these all departments falls into finance. So payables department, they'll process the payments to suppliers. Receivables department, they'll collect the payments from customers. Asset department, they'll maintain all the assets, related to organization. Cash or treasury department, they'll be maintaining the cash. And common department, or say general department, they'll just prepare the reports, based on the activities which takes place across the different departments. Fine, that's all. Just it's a very high level just information when you talk about specific department. Let's move to next slide. So here, Oracle Financials applications. When you say Oracle Financial applications, as a part of Oracle Financials application, we have five applications. Just now we discussed what is the meaning of application. Application consists of forms related to specific department related process. The every form will be connected with the database. That means simply you can say every application will be connected with the database. Once data is available based on the transactions which you do in the respective department, so the same data would be available for reporting. That means when you say application, forms, database, and the data which will be available for reporting purpose. So that is a point we have to understand. When you talk about Oracle Financial applications, here primarily these are the five applications which comes under core financials. So those applications are Oracle Accounts Payable, Oracle Accounts Receivable application, Oracle Fixed Assets, Oracle Cash Management, and Oracle General Ledger. So Oracle Accounts Payables. Accounts Payable simply you can call as AP, Account Receivables ER, Fixed Assets FA, Cash Management CM, General Ledger GL. Okay, so these are the five applications we call as Oracle Financial applications. Since these applications are developed by Oracle, we are calling as Oracle Financial applications. If these applications are developed by some XYZ company, simply you can call as XYZ financial application. It's very simple. Who developed that application, so that you can add as a prefix. That's what we see any applications in the market. Okay, so why this application is required? Oracle Accounts Payables application. So when you talk about payables department, what are the payables department do? All the activities, all the payables department related information you can maintain by using Accounts Payables application. Account Receivables. So what are the activities Receivables department do? All the activities related information we can record in the Receivables department. Asset department related activities we can record within the Fixed Assets module application. And Cash or Treasury department, what are the information they have to manage? That information you can capture or you can maintain by using Oracle Cash Management application. And general department, we discussed common or general department. What they do, they'll prepare the reports. So that reporting and all you can do by using the Oracle General Ledger. Now we'll go to next slide, which is more detail about this in these five applications. Just move to next slide. Here the first application is Oracle Accounts Payables, AP. Okay, so from what we can do by using Oracle Accounts Payable. So whatever the payables department do, I request you all to mute from your end, so that there won't be any noise. Please. Fine. So when you talk about Oracle financial applications, just now we discussed we have total five core financial applications.
Mandar.
I could hear some noise. Okay, fine. Fine. So when you talk about Oracle accounts payable, so accounts payables, so what are the activities? This application can be used by payables department in any organization. Typically, what activities payables department do? They'll just maintain the vouchers information, they'll be processing the payments to suppliers. So by using our Oracle accounts payable application, we can record the purchase invoices. We can record the purchase invoices. So whenever purchasing department procures something from the supplier, okay, so supplier will be sending the invoice, that invoice information will be received by payables department. The payables department will create purchase invoice in Oracle accounts payables if the company is going to use our Oracle ERP. Okay, by using this Oracle accounts payable application, the company can record their purchase invoices, which they can create against their purchases. So when they have purchase invoice, that purchase invoice will have information like who is the supplier and how much we have to pay, when we have to pay, how we have to pay, means through check or cash, and all the information will be maintaining as a part of purchase invoices. So then if you want to make the payment, okay, that activity also you can do as a part of payables department. That means the accounts payables department is responsible to maintain the purchase invoices as well as payments. They'll maintain the purchase invoice and they'll be processing the payments. Typically, this activity will be done by payables department in any organization. The same activities or same information can be maintained by application called as Oracle Accounts Payable. Any question from anyone? I could hear some. Praveen, can you mute from your end? I could see all the time you are just unmuting. If you have any question, you can just unmute and you can raise your question. We can discuss on that. Fine. So that's all about payables department do. The same activities can be handled by Oracle accounts payable application. And other department is receivables department. What receivables department do? So whenever sales department do the sales, against the sales, they'll be collecting the invoice, sales invoice from the sales department, and based on that proof of sale, they'll be contacting the customer to collect the payment. So typically the receivables department will maintain the sales invoices and they'll record the payment whenever they receive from the customer. The same activities can be performed by using Oracle accounts receivable. We call as AR, Oracle accounts receivable, we call as AR. By using account receivable application, we can record the sales invoice. Whenever sales department do some sales activity, against the sales activity, we record the sales invoice. And against the sales invoices, or say against the sale, whenever we get the payment from the customer, that will be recording by using Oracle accounts receivable. It's a very simple activities which we do in this specific applications, or say so department related activities. So these are all specific department related activities we are going to record in the specific application. By using Oracle account receivable, we can create the sales invoices and we can record the customer payments, or just call it as receipts or cash receipts. That's all. And cash or treasury department, what they do, they'll maintain the cash. How generally cash can be maintained? With the help of bank accounts. The business point of view, the cash related, just cash you will maintain through bank accounts only. So what treasury department or cash department will do, they'll maintain the bank accounts and they'll do the reconciliations. Okay, the same information, the same activities you can perform as a part of system by using Oracle cash management. How many bank accounts are owned by company, all the bank accounts, the reality, how many accounts you have, all the accounts you can create in the cash management application, and against that bank accounts, what are the transactions you perform, based on that we'll be getting the statement. The statement we can use for bank statement reconciliation, BRS. Okay, so we'll maintain all the bank accounts by using the application called as Oracle cash management, and we'll be performing the bank statement reconciliation. Bank statement reconciliation means in payables, accounts payables, we'll have a payments information. In account receivables, we'll have a receipts information. So this information would be available as a part of our system that you can treat as a cash book, and we will request the banker to provide the bank statement, and we'll be cross-checking the bank statement with our books of records related to payments which we processed and payments which we received from our customer, whether these are reflecting properly in our bank statement or not, or any fraud transactions we have in the bank statement to validate and to verify. We always perform the bank statement reconciliation. So typically the cash management, by using the cash management application, you can maintain the bank accounts and do bank statement reconciliations you can perform. Here, the very key activities which we do in each and every application or say department we are discussing. Okay, once we get into the application, there are some other activities also which you can perform, but remember always these are very primary. Okay. By using accounts payable application, we can record the purchase invoice and payments with the receivables. We can record the sales invoice and do customer payments. By using the cash management application, we can maintain the bank accounts and we can perform the bank statement reconciliations. The next application name is Oracle Fixed Assets. Okay, what asset department do? Primarily, they'll maintain all the assets. How many assets we have in our organization? All the assets we can create and maintain by using Oracle Fixed Assets. So based on the usage, we'll be calculating the depreciation. If depreciation is applicable, we'll calculate. Otherwise, we are not going to calculate depreciation. We'll be appreciating. Take simple example, land. In case of land, we never do the depreciation in general scenarios. For land, always there will be appreciation. So we'll be updating the cost accordingly. If you have some vehicles, buildings, furniture, and some other assets, which are being used in your organization, for that always will be calculating the depreciation. So those activities can be handled by asset department in the organization. Whatever the asset department we have, for the asset department can use the application called as Oracle Fixed Assets to maintain the assets and to calculate the depreciation, to have a proper records as a part of system which will sync with the reality. So other application name is Oracle General Ledger. Within Oracle General Ledger, what we do, we'll prepare the financial reports. How do we prepare the financial reports? From payables, accounts payables, we'll get purchase invoice and payments into General Ledger application. From receivables, sales invoice and do customer payments. And from cash management, the cash information. From assets and depreciation information. From different applications, all the data we can move to Oracle General Ledger application. So against the data, you'll be able to prepare the financial reports. These are the five, primarily these are the five applications which you are going to learn as a core modules. Apart from these five, we have a few other modules also which we have to understand, and where we should have some basic information, basic knowledge when we work on these five modules. Okay, so this is what just we have to understand here. Now next point is product families in Oracle applications. So we have many applications from Oracle. We have around 300 applications from Oracle. When you talk about financials, we have core applications as a five applications, as we discussed here, AP, AR, CM, FA and GL. So the same I given here, Oracle financials, GL, AP, AR, CM and FA. These five comes under core financial application. So these five applications will support for the financial related business process within any organization. In the same way, based on the applications, what are the applications we have? See, earlier we discussed the group of forms. We can group multiple forms based on the specific department related activities that we can call as application. In the same way, we can group multiple applications which will support specific business process or specific primary business process. So the group of applications which are very much relevant and well connected with the respective business process, that you can call as product family. The product family is nothing but group of applications. Okay, group of applications, group of forms, reports, and with the database connectivity we are calling as application. But group of applications you can call as specific product family. So these are the different product families that are available in our Oracle applications. We have many, but just for our understanding, I given few here. So one is Oracle Financials. As a part of Oracle Financials, these are the applications we have. GL, AP, AR, CM, FA. Already discussed what is the meaning. GL means General Ledger. Simply you can call as Oracle General Ledger. AP accounts payables, nothing but Oracle accounts payables. AR accounts receivable, Oracle account receivable. CM cash management, you can call as Oracle cash management since the product is developed by Oracle. And FA fixed assets, Oracle fixed assets. So these five applications belongs to Oracle Financials product family. In the same way, we have Oracle supply chain management, we call as SCM, like financials, okay, supply chain management, the short name is SCM. So as a part of the supply chain management, there are few key applications, those I mentioned here. Oracle purchasing, we call as PO. So within the purchasing, majorly we record the purchase orders. That is the reason the name they given as a PO. And we have Oracle inventory and Oracle order management. We'll discuss more detail level about these applications also. When we are going to work on these financials, definitely you should understand what purpose these applications are going to be used and how these financials and supply chain management application will get connected based on the any business process. These points will be understanding more detail level. So here we have one product family called as Oracle Financials, other product family SCM. The same way we have Oracle Human Capital Management, HCM, or you can call as HRMS, Human Resource Management System. Okay, Oracle Human Capital Management, HCM, as a part of that, we have many applications, the core HR, payroll, talent management, we have a few more applications. In the same way, other product families, Oracle CRM, okay, Customer Relationship Management. So within that, we'll have a list of applications. In the same way, Oracle projects. So as a part of projects, again, we'll have a modules like costing, billing, project management, okay, resource management, different applications we'll be having. So this is how we have a different product families within Oracle applications. Okay, so the group of forms generally we can define as a application which will support for specific department related activities. So multiple department related activities, okay, you can, the multiple department related applications you can group, okay, which are very much relevant and which will involve in the same business related functions or activities or process, those you can call as product families. So these are the examples for product families. We have financial, supply chain management, HCM, SCM, HCM, and CRM projects. So these are the few examples for product families. Now we are going to learn Oracle Financials. Fine. So the next point here is ERP, Enterprise Resource Planning. So here this point we'll discuss a bit later. First we have to see the application, we have to understand certain things, then you can have a better understanding on this point, but very high level I'll give you simple information. So here if you take example, say here, so when you talk about, when you look at this slide, so here you can see that different department related applications. Say here fixed assets department, AP means accounts payables department, PO means purchasing department, and ER means account receivables, OM means order management. These are the different departments. So when you look at any organizations, definitely there should be some communication should takes place between those departments to sync all the areas of the activities which takes place. Say for example, you got an order from the customer. The order will be received by sales department. Sales department should communicate with inventory department to check the stock availability. Again, that inventory department, stock is not available, they have to communicate with the purchasing department. So if purchasing department is going to purchase, they have to pass that information to payables department saying that we purchased so-and-so item from so-and-so supplier and please process the payment. Once payment is done by payables department, that information again we have to pass to cash department for bank statement reconciliation purpose. So this is how, like, if you are going to do any activity within the organization, that is not going to be very independent. Definitely every business activity, business transaction which you do as a part of system, that will have a dependency. Okay, that will have a some dependency. Okay, so that is the reason just we have to understand, okay, certain points where, like, each and every, I mean, within the organization, different departments will, all the departments, some cases maybe few departments may not be involved in the respective process, but most of the cases all the departments will have a communication. That only here just we mentioned these are the different departments, okay, which you can just considered as a some communication between the organization related process. Okay. So fine. So here I'll take simple example here. Say this is general ledger application. This is general ledger application. One second here. Fine. So here we have a purchasing department. Here we can see purchasing department. So if there is some any requirement, if there could be some department will raise their requirements, and from there the information should pass to purchasing department. The purchasing department will purchase, that information should be passed to this inventory department. Okay, when stock is available within the inventory, that inventory department will be passing that information, maybe for project. There may be some stock required within the project. So when inventory department is going to pass any some stock, if they are going to issue some material to project, the project should communicate that information with the AP, accounts payables department. In other way, like again, the costing department will involve in the product related information which is going to be stored here. And again, the same way, like here, there are other departments, work in process, manufacturing, bill of material, engineering, all these based on your business process, there will be some sort of communication should be established between the departments. Okay, the same way OM, order management. Okay, say for example, there is some order from the customer. So once they do the sales activity, so before that they have to the order management. Okay, sales department, simply you can say sales department, they have to check the stock available within the inventory department. If stock is available, they'll do the sales activity. Okay, and they will be communicating that information with account receivables department. The same way sales and marketing will keep in touch with this is order management department. Here they will be processing the orders, but order process will be supported by sales department. Okay, sales process will be supported by marketing department. So this is how there will be some dependency, and they should have a very tight interactions in the process of executing something. The same way like services and this. Sorry,
I have a question.
Please.
Yeah, actually when a sales order is coming from order management, at what point they create a requisition? So they will check the inventory first and they create requisition and PO?
No,
or how does it work?
Simple point, when you say you are getting the order from the customer, okay, that means you are acting as a supplier, right? You have your order management. You are getting the order means you are getting from whom? Your customer, right?
Okay.
That means your customer has a requirement. So your customer will raise the requisition in his organization.
Okay.
Right?
So okay.
Here
so it's
all the departments. These all departments we have as a part of our organization. We are getting the sales order means we are not going to get from the purchasing department of our organization, right? Order will be getting from our customer purchasing department, right? We'll be discussing. We have a complete process, detailed process which we have to understand, but here just I am trying to give you this information very high level. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. So here, this is how just each and every department should have some communication. Say for example, so the purchasing department purchased some asset. The PO has to pass that information to accounts payable saying that we purchased so and so asset, so please make the payment. The AP department, accounts payables department, what they have to do? That information they have to pass to FA, fixed assets department, saying that so and so asset we purchased, you make a note, record. Okay, that's how they'll be sending. The same way, so here there will be payroll department, they'll have a communication for HRMS, the people information is required in the payroll to process the salaries. Okay, and the same way HRMS department can raise the requisition for the resource to work in the organization. So again, that goes to purchasing PO, they'll raise the PO to the outsourcing company or some other individual functions of the processes. where we can get the resource on contract base or direct employees, whatever. So that's how the each and every, like if you are going to deal with a specific activity, like as a particular transaction part of any department, those are connected with the other departments. They will have a dependency. It has to happen as a process, which happens between the departments. So that means there should be some very good communication channel between the departments. So however the organization department should have a communication, okay, the same sort of communication can be established in the system environment by using the product called as software product called as ERP applications. So enterprise resource planning, here enterprise organization, okay, so resource, when you say resource, you can say resource people, you can call as resource. That means the people you can plan, how to utilize the resource, you can plan by using the HRMS application. And other resource, I can say material. Material you can maintain within the inventory and you can plan how to use and for what process, what sort of items you can plan. And other resource, you can say money. The money just you can maintain within the finance, and that you can plan how to use it, how to just utilize it. Okay. And in the same way, some machinery, if you are going to use in your organization, just any machinery, that also how you are going to use. And so simply you can say, one way you can say here as a part of fixed assets, what are the assets we are going to have? Those could be some machinery or some assets, how you are going to utilize and how you are going to manage all this information here. When you say resource, manpower, say people and money and material and machinery, they all comes under resource. Within the organization, we'll use the different resources. People we use, okay, people will be working and machinery will be running and money will be using, okay, and all these will be using. So within the enterprise, what are the different resources we have to utilize in the better way? You can have a better plan accordingly, you will be able to execute by using the system called as ERP. Because however normal communication takes place, however the process should work as per the organization, to support the process as is, there is a system which we call as ERP. In the ERP, for each and every department, we can have a separate application. Okay, between those applications, there will be connectivity to pass them information. So if you have information in PO, automatically it will go to AP. You don't need to just create record here again. Say you have a requisition, automatically the requisition will go to purchasing, and that from purchasing, automatically the information based on the process, it goes to AP. From AP, information goes to GL. From here again, it will just goes to GL, FA. So wherever the information, the communication normally in the business, how it takes place, okay, so the same process related solution is implemented in the ERP applications. So again, all these different department related application related data can be stored in one single database. So for each and every application, you don't need to maintain the separate database. Within the single database, you can maintain. So anytime, any information, anybody required, with a one click, they can get that information. That's how that every information will be well connected. At the single click, that any information would be available, so that they can take some very just immediate decisions, or they can take required action to understand. Otherwise, if there is no communication between the system, process or real business, so whatever you are trying to do, there will be too much of delay. If there is, see, for example, so I want to create invoice and accounts payables. If accounts payable is not connected with the purchasing application, PO application, so I have to get all the information and I have to enter each and every details within the PO, AP, accounts payables. So if PO is connected with this, based on the records, whatever available within the PO, you can create invoice and AP automatically. You don't need to enter. The same information what is available here, which is required in FA, automatically will flow from here to here, from here to here. That's how that the source transaction, how you are processing accordingly, you can take that same record information, the different departments based on their relevant process. That's how you can just avoid a lot of duplication and manual work. So this kind of synchronization and streamlined processes available within ERP only. Not only this, there are many advantages. Going forward, we'll be discussing. So what is the real advantage of ERP apart from these points? Okay. So that's all about ERP. We'll talk on that. We should understand more information. I don't think this is the right time to talk on that. So where it won't get connected for many of the guys. So we'll see something, then we'll talk more on that. So other point here is Oracle application versions. What are the different versions are available from Oracle with respect to this Oracle applications? We'll see that. So the previous release we call as 11i. Okay, 11i. I stands for internet. These applications can be operated through internet. That is the reason they're given version as 11i. So Oracle e-business suite. Okay, that means what are the applications here we discussed? Okay, these different product families. These all product families are going to be in the e-business suite only. Okay, within the all the application, the group of applications, different product families, all will be part of e-business suite. That's how they're given the name. Within the Oracle e-business suite, we have a different product families, and within each and every product family, we have a different applications which will support specific department related activities. This is a very older version. Okay, now Oracle stopped providing the support also. Who are the very big clients, big customers, okay, for them only Oracle is supporting. Now there are no implementations are happening on 11i version. Now the running in the market, you can see most of the projects are running on release 12. Okay, R12 means release 12, release name. So this is also comes under Oracle e-business suite. Okay, Oracle e-business suite. So we call as release 12. So this 11i or release 12 are Oracle own products. So after that, what Oracle did is they acquired many other ERP products from the market. By taking the best features or best product, best applications or best product families from the different ERP products, they built one application called as Fusion Applications that we call as 11G. Okay, we call as 11G. That's the version they're given, which we call as Fusion Applications or Fusion Cloud, depending on usage we'll be calling. So this is what we have to understand. This is we have a good market, good scope in the market. Okay, for release 12, there are few projects are happening on the Fusion applications, but here is the good we can find good market for release 12. This is a older, it's a future version. This is a current version, you can say. Okay, but still on this Fusion applications also, there are some projects are going on, but the most of the projects, if you see 100 projects who are using Oracle applications, you can see more than 90 plus 95 you can see on release 12 only. Maybe 4 or 5 you can see with the Fusion applications. Okay, it's not Fusion applications are not that much stabilized when you compare with EBS. Simply you can call as EBS, EBS, e-business suite. Simply you can call as EBS also. Okay, these two comes under EBS. 11i and R12 comes under EBS, Oracle EBS. So this 11G we call as Fusion applications. Any question here, please?
So this Oracle Fusion applications, and now they're talking about this Oracle ERP cloud, is the same?
Yeah, cloud same. So cloud, when you say this Oracle Fusion applications can be, you can subscribe through cloud services. When you say cloud, the servers will be deployed at Oracle. They'll be giving access to use it, that technology, that way of usage we call as a cloud. So otherwise you can have your own server and you can maintain your applications that you call as on-premise. If you don't want to buy the server infrastructure where you will install, you will be using, just you can give the task to Oracle only. Just they will be providing the access to your product and you will be accessing through cloud. Both are same. Okay. How you will be accessing, whether you have your own server, then call as on-premise. You don't have your own server, so the servers will be maintained by Oracle and they'll be giving the access for the respective product areas, products. So that model we call as cloud. There are a few other points to understand, but the simple way to understand, that's what we have to take that point. Okay, so these are the different versions available. 11i older, release 12, the current running popular version, and this Fusion application 11g is going to be future version. And who will be eligible for this course? It's a very simple point. The very first point is, the who can speak basic English, they are eligible. with other points consideration. So if somebody is attending this session or if somebody is planning to do this course who just passed out their bachelor degree, they are not eligible. They can do it, but there is no good scope in the market to get the jobs. As a fresher, you cannot get any job. So most of the guys who passed out their bachelor degree 2 years back, 3 years back, 4 years back, they'll be doing this course and they'll be planning how to get the job, and there are many ways which they are trying. So if you are just passed out your bachelor degree, I'm not talking about master degree, bachelor degree. If you just passed out your bachelor degree, normally people don't recommend you to do this sort of courses. So just who has some, you say you passed out your bachelor's 3 years back, 4 years back, in that case, you can choose this course and you can learn proper way, you can get ready with the product knowledge, then you will be getting the scope to get into any organization. So with a very good salaries, that sort of scope is available. Okay. So, and other points, you no need to worry about your educational background. Your educational background may be, say, MBA, or else it could be some technical background, BTech or MTech or MCA, okay, or BCA, whatever. Doesn't matter. Only the point here is you have to learn this product, okay, and you have to be very sound in this product knowledge. Then definitely you can get a job. If you are going to try as a fresher, definitely they will look at your educational background also. In that case, they'll be preferring. Generally, you don't see openings for the freshers, but if you find somewhere, in that case, definitely they will look at your educational background. So if you fall into the scenario where you completed your bachelor degree few years back and you are doing this course, in that case, so that won't become any issue and you can learn properly and you can get ready and you can get ready with your profile and you can just post in the job portal, you can start getting the calls, and you have to just prove yourself by talking about this product, how much you are sound when you talk about these financials and all, whatever we are going to discuss, okay, that will help you to get through that interview process and all. We'll talk on that more detail level. Okay, the simple point is the basic communication skills. And freshers, this course is not recommendable. And who has minimum like 3-4 years back, who completed their bachelor's, they can plan for this course. How to go ahead, that we'll be discussing anyway, detail level. Okay. The other point here is once you learn this course, we will be just working as a functional consultants. We'll be working as Oracle functional consultants. The functional consultant can belong to financials, or SCM, CRM, or projects. In our case, we will be working as Oracle financial functional consultant. Being a functional consultant, what typically we'll be doing? What would be our role and responsibility? There are many points to understand, but I didn't mention all these points in this stage here to discuss. So simple point is once you learn this product, you'll be knowing what is possible, what is not possible through these applications. We'll be learning most of the things will be possible. So that's how Oracle developed, by understanding the global business requirements. So if you are, after learning this course, once you get the job, so when you are working for the project, what we have to do is primarily we have to take the business requirement, client requirement, for whom we are going to implement, which a company is going to use this product. Okay, we have to take their requirements, what they do as a part of payables department, what they do as a part of the receivables department, what they do as a part of asset department, all the information will be taking, how they are doing their business, that information will be taking, that we call as requirement gathering. So after that, we'll do the solution design and all, many activities will be there, that let it be high level. Let's proceed with the 2-3 points. We'll take the requirement, accordingly we will set up the system ready. So whatever, we'll be learning this, how to set up and what is the meaning of setting up our configuration, we'll be learning. For the first very major point here is, as being a functional consultant, we'll take the business requirement, accordingly we'll set up the system, and we'll educate the users by just explaining, by giving the demonstrations, how to use the system. When they're using, we will be helping them, okay, as a part of support. Okay, so now the plan is we'll be learning. When you learn the product, you'll come to know how it works. Then once you get into the project, you have to understand, okay, say for example, in accounts payables, there could be 10 futures. But when you are going to work for a specific company, a client, the client, as per client business process, they may require only 4 or 5 features, for example. So in that case, you know 10 features are available. So when you are taking the requirement, they'll be giving what they need. Based on the requirement in payables, they may need only 5 features. So that you will be understanding as their requirement. Accordingly, you will set up system where system will allow them to perform those activities within the payables application. Then how to use the payable applications will be explaining to the business users. Then they'll start using. If they have any issues with that usage, they'll contact us. We'll be helping because we'll be knowing the end-to-end application, the product, how it works, okay, how to set it up, how to change it, how to facilitate certain functionality process. So that is the reason. Just we'll be having great command on the product. If they have any issue, they will be able to support them. It's a very high level I given. There are many activities. We'll take the requirement, we'll do the mapping, solution design, many points are there. Those all I'll explain, you will discuss as a part of real-time discussions. Okay, we'll be just spending around 10 hours time, okay, to understand about how real-time projects takes place, how implementation takes place, how support projects happens, how rollouts happen, how upgrades takes place, other points all we'll be discussing as a part of the real-time discussions. Just here, just very high level, I'm just giving the information. Being a functional consultant, very primarily, these are the activities we'll be involving. Okay, so there are many other, just I just mentioned to give you some understanding, since people, just some guys will be expecting to know what we'll be doing. So very simple thing. Once you are ready with the product knowledge, take the requirement, and based on that, you'll design the solution. Accordingly, you'll set up the system ready. You'll train the users, they'll use and will support. Okay. And the next point, when you talk about opportunities, so when you talk about Oracle Financials, out of all the Oracle related products, families, the primary product families, financials only. We have plenty of opportunities in the market. Only we have to get ready with the product knowledge. Okay, it won't become challenge to get one job what you are looking for. Okay, so we don't need to worry about it. We have a global market. So you can get job in India or else in any Middle East countries or other countries like US, UK, just in different many countries. So many just big organizations are using this Oracle product, since it's a very popular from Oracle. So opportunities wise, we don't need to worry about it. Okay, we have plenty of opportunities. Here, other point here, syllabus, what modules we are going to cover as a core modules, what modules we are going to cover as a basic, a basic functionality process, and that I'll take you through the course curriculum. Just give me a second. So here, so this is a course curriculum we have for our this training program. So these are the modules we are going to cover. Primarily, we'll be covering Oracle General Ledger, Accounts Payables, Receivables, Cash Management, Fixed Assets. These are the core modules, which you can say as financials. Okay. So when you are going to work on these modules, when you are working on payables process, receivables process, there will be requirement wherever tax is applicable, you have to calculate. To calculate the tax and payables or receivables, we'll use the Oracle e-business tax application. And it's a subledger accounting, it's a certain functionality for accounting generation point of view, that also we'll be discussing. And the basic HRMS, how to create the employees, okay. That we'll be discussing, because when you are going to work on financials, we require employee information also. That is the reason, just we'll be working on HRMS part to create the organizations, to create the employees, their job positions, to test different scenarios. And we'll be working on basic functionalities of inventory also, how to create the stock, how to check the availability, how to create the inventory organizations. So purchasing also basic functionality. I'll be working how to create the requisitions, purchase orders, receipts. So those will be creating from the purchasing application. Order management, will be working on this to understand. So how to create the sales orders, how to process the sales orders. And the system administrator, this is administration part. When you are going to do the implementations, we have to use this application to start with the application, the environment, so business, the organization environment, create. We have to do the same environment we have to create in the system environment. For that reason, we'll use this system administrator application to do the required configuration. So in all these applications, we'll be completing all the required setups, and but major will be focusing on these five modules, which are core financials. So when we are working, so we'll be touching these applications also, what level of knowledge we require when we are going to work on Oracle financial applications. So that's how we'll do it. Again, that complete training will be, will be running when you are going to work in the real project, what approach we follow, how we do the system related configuration and the process or anything, and that base one will be running. Just that's what I just mentioned here. Note, entire training delivered in multi-org environment. Multi-org environment means if you are going to do the implementation for any company, the client, how they are doing the business, where they are doing the business, how they are managing all the activities, that same we have to replicate into the system as a multi-org environment. We'll discuss more detail level, and the P2P and O2C cycles, complete sales, right from sales to till we get the payment from, we'll get the order from the process starts with order and will end with the customer payment, which we call as O2C, order to cash. P2P, complete procurement and payment process, all will be covered here. The two will be covering. Okay, and other benefits here, as we mentioned, each class we record, and the recorded videos will be sharing with all the participants, and we can provide 6 months instance access. If you need more than 6 months, yes, we can extend to one more or two more months. Okay.
Hello.
Yeah, please.
Any question? Yeah, I have one question on this. What is Oracle Applications Technical and Oracle Apps DBA?
Okay, so simple. So Oracle DBA will be primarily just simple DBA point here to understand. The DBA, what they do is, once we take the license from the Oracle, they will maintain the server. They will install the application to server, and they'll just take the backup of the entire product. Okay, and they'll do the maintenance activities. That is a part of DBA, administration part. And technical, okay, we'll be discussing these points very detailed level as a part of real-time discussions. But so to give a quick answer to your question, technical people, say for example, in accounts payables, our client is going doing certain activity, but to support that activity, we don't have certain form. When we don't have some form which is required by our client, our customer, that has to be developed. The development will be done by technical people.
Okay.
Being a functional consultant, we'll be working on what functionality is available, which is given by Oracle. That's what we have to know, and we'll be working on that process. If something is not available, we will pass that information to technical people. They'll come into the picture to do the form development, or else say client require one report. Anyway, Oracle will provide the many reports in each and every application, but as per business requirement, there may be need of additional reports. So that we cannot do anything. Whatever the reports are available, that we should know, and that we should be able to pass to the client. If any new report is required, we will take that requirement from the business, which report they require, which information need to be fetched into that report. That information will pass to technical people. Technical people will develop the report. They do majorly developments. Okay.
So in this course, the technical and DBA part will not be covered, or can it be covered?
No, different roles. It's a functional. Those are so you don't see somebody who will be working as DBA and functional.
Okay.
So see, if you want, you can see very few guys who will be working as technical and functional. But you should have you can start with the functional. You can get into the company. You can start working in the project. Once you get some level of experience, then you can anytime you can learn technical just to enhance your skill. Okay, that's how it works. Okay. The more scope for functional only. Okay. If you see the team size in one project, just for example, 10 members. So out of 10 members, you can see one DBA. Okay, and 6 to 7 functional, 1 or 2
okay.
Technical. Again, technical is not required
for functional.
Six to seven technical, functional, 1 or 2 technical. minimum one technical resource is required depending on how many new things need to be developed. Normally what you develop in the application which is not available, we call as customization. To do certain customizations, are there some basic activities need to be done by technical people. So that's how it works. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. So these are the points here. 6 months instance access will be providing. We'll provide some documentation part. If required, we can prepare the profile for you to start with your job. I mean, to find your job and all. And we'll have some interview related discussion also. And we will conduct some real time related sessions to give you the complete required information to understand all about it. So when you talk about the module wise, application wise, so application you can call as a module also. Module is a technical term. You can call as Oracle General Ledger application or Oracle General Ledger module. Okay, you can call as module also. So when I talk about General Ledger, these are the things we are going to set up and these are the areas which we are going to learn. Okay, most of the things we are going to cover. So that is the reason it's going to be 120 hours. Okay. So this is accounts payables. From accounts payables, these all we are going to learn different setups and the different business scenarios to support different futures. What we have all will be covering. And from accounts payables, these are the concepts we are going to cover. From cash management, these are the concepts. And from fixed assets, these are the concepts. And from e-business tax. And from SLA and from HRMS, what we'll be learning and inventory. So what level of knowledge we require from other applications, that also we are going to cover. So primarily our financial related, most of the concepts we are going to cover. So this is all about course curriculum, which we designed for this training program. If you have any questions, you can raise those questions. We can discuss now. Any questions from anyone, please?
Lakshmanji.
Yep.
Lakshmanji, on the instance which is going to be given to us, are we really going to configure on the instance? I mean, how to configure the software, how to put the journal entries, both these aspects are going to be practiced on the same?
See, you will become master on that process. I'm going to cover from the scratch. Okay, we are going to do everything from the scratch. If you get a fresh instance, fresh product from Oracle, okay, once you take the license, whatever you get as fresh environment, in that environment, how to work. So that I am going to show. So how we'll be doing the real-time project, that approach we are going to follow.
Okay, thank you.
Yep, thanks.
Now the question is, you guys going to give the access to 6 months for us for the instance to practice, right? So are we going to get the instance soon or after this course?
No, just once we start with the system related classes, we'll be starting. Say initially there could be few classes where we should understand thoroughly the concepts, the conceptual understanding we should get. Once we are ready with that, maybe after few sessions, we'll start with the system. The moment we start with the system, you need system access to just replicate the same, right? You have to start doing the same from your end for your learning. So we'll be providing. So today we started the session, maybe by next week we'll be getting the instance.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, please.
Hello. So is there any difference between Oracle R12 and Fusion?
So finance point of view, they taken as this same solution they taken. There are few differences, but so it won't be a good idea to start directly with the fusion. The fusion will be learning the guys, one point, the guys who are already working on Oracle R12, EBS R12, what we are discussing now. The guys who are working with us years of experience, just they are learning to upgrade. If you know this R12 financials,
okay.
So I don't say you have to learn fusion. I'll say just simply you have to upgrade. You know the big difference between learning and from the scratch and upgrading, right? Upgradation means just it's all about updating wherever the gaps between those two. Okay, if
so,
Oracle R12 financials, I can say you know 80% fusion. That's it.
Okay. So I thought there will be any major differences between the R12 and fusion.
What Oracle it is? So Oracle built the fusion applications by taking the different product families or solutions from the different ERPs. Okay. Fortunately, Oracle taken our Oracle R12 solution into fusion.
Okay, fine.
And they did small changes to have a better synchronization with the different other products.
Okay.
That's it.
Cheers.
Yeah. So in this stage, So in this stage, if you learn Oracle R12 financials, you can get job. But in the same, in this stage, if you learn Fusion, you may not get. The reason for the guys who knows Fusion, they should have the foundation of R12 also. So that is recommended in the market. Some company is going to hire. Definitely, they look at their profile whether this guy is experienced or has knowledge on Oracle R12 financials. So that sort of criteria we have. Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah. One quick question. Oracle Fusion and Oracle Cloud, one and the same?
I think the same point we discussed here. See, the terms are Oracle Fusion. Fusion Financials. Let's say Fusion Financials. Oracle. Fine, simple point. So you have, this is a product name. Actually, this is a product name. Like we have Oracle R12 Financials. In the same way, this is another product as a part of Fusion, Oracle Fusion Financials. Now, see two options we have. This product you have to maintain in your own server. Okay, one option is you can buy the server and you can install this product, Oracle Fusion Financial applications into that server. That is one option. Other one, you can go with some service providers. I'll say data centers. Okay, you are not going to buy any server and all, they'll be maintaining within that, the application. So now you can install that Oracle Fusion Financials in your own server. Other option is you can go with some service provider, some vendor support who will be maintaining your Oracle Financial application. Now you will be installing, they will be installing your product here. They will take care of it. So this, if you are going to install in your own server, that you can call as product name as is. And if you are going to maintain the same in the data centers where they'll be giving the option, like here I take in the data centers, normally you say like Oracle. So you don't want to buy any your own server. You want to maintain the same product in Oracle servers. And when you maintain this product in Oracle servers, you can access those servers from anywhere, anytime. Even in your own server also you can do. Technically there is a lot of difference. So if you are going to maintain this Oracle Fusion Financial in your own server, you call with the same name. If your applications are going to be managed, maintained by Oracle within the Oracle servers, so that way of use is you call as cloud. Now you add cloud term here. When you see cloud, product remains same. How you are accessing? From your own server or from Oracle services. So based on that, you can name it. Product is same. Own server means call with the same name. It's not own server. Oracle manager servers, which we call as cloud service. So since you are using the cloud service to maintain your application, okay, you call it as, for the same, you will be including the term called as cloud, that we call as Oracle Fusion Cloud Financials. There won't be any difference in product, only the way how you maintain and do access. That's all. Okay, any other questions, please?
Lakshman, I have a doubt.
Please.
This is Komal.
Yeah, please.
Lakshman, I am from AR actually, Accounts Receivable Department. I have a hands-on experience on Oracle 11i, which my company uses it. But if I learn this R12, will I have any jobs in the market currently? I know the situation is not so good. So
definitely.
Will that be helpful?
You might
do we really
accountant or say end user in your current organization where you just
limit end user.
Sorry?
Yes, I'm an end user.
Yeah. So you'll be just working on the process. You don't know. Okay, now you are just, you'll be creating the billing, right? You'll be creating the receivables transactions. You may create the receipts. The remittance activities will be performing. To do all these activities, okay, we have to set up system ready. That means already the configuration is done. The system made ready to use, you are using. So if you learn this course, how to set up the system ready to use, that you'll be learning. So you'll be just helping others to know about the process, how to use that application, then they'll be using. Okay, now you are just working as an end user and just it's like a transaction entry process. So if you learn this course, you can forget about what you are doing now. And if you are going to learn, as you said, you are working on receivables process. Okay, so you may not work on that process, but if you are going to learn this course, definitely you can get the job. But frankly speaking, you should have enough time in your hand to attend the classes and do the practice multiple times. To spend time to read and remember all this stuff, then definitely you'll be able to get the job. Okay, irrespective of your previous profile. And if you have some relevant, yes, definitely that would be added advantage. But even if you say your educational background is technical and purely you are working on some programming job, no issues, you can learn. Okay, because in the financials, you can see the term as financials, frankly speaking, everything is automated in the system. You don't need to write any accounting entries, nothing. Everything they programmed. Just you have to know how to perform the transaction, then automatic system will take care of the accounting. But when you are working, we'll come to know, even if you are from technical background, you'll come to know how that accounting is taking place. Those are limited transactions only we'll be doing. So that information would be enough. If you work for one project, you can become a master in that process also. Okay, if you have some accounting background, okay, that is added. Okay.
No, I don't have an account.
Yeah. Okay. Fine.
Yeah.
So that
Lakshmanji.
Thank you, Lakshman.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, please go ahead.
Lakshmanji, that these Oracle certifications and examinations, does it really required for the job for a person being a fresher like me?
Okay, I'll talk on that. 1 second. Yeah, please. Any other questions from anyone, please? Fine. So no questions. We'll connect tomorrow same time. The guys who are interested who want to continue. You can just tomorrow also same time. We'll be sending the meeting link. You can just join and we can continue from here.
Questions? Lakshman, I have one question.
Please go ahead.
Oracle financial applications time, we are building forms, so we are check the backend and database level tables.
Yeah, you can check it. I'll show you the process.
Okay. What are the your something if you build the form and enter the some input values?
Yeah. See, I'll take you through that.
And storing the data.
Also, 1 point. I'll take you through the information, which data will be stored in which table, the table name. All the information I'll be providing as a part of this training.
Okay, if you any general reports time you were teaching any BA publisher this corresponding reports?
So BA publisher comes under technical. It's all about defining the templates and formats. Okay, that doesn't come under okay. functional part. Okay.
Okay.
Working in the projects, if you see some new requirement from the clients, they need some new report and that has to be BA. Okay, BIP. So in that case, we'll take the requirement and we'll pass to the technical team. The BA developer will do that report definition.
Okay, this Oracle financial applications time, if a general reports will be building, that time what tool will be using?
See, the BA case, you'll be using the BI tool only, or else we have different tools which we can use from Oracle also. We have a report builders, okay, Oracle report builder, the tool we have. And
okay,
that you can use, and we can, based on some clients will be using the same reporting which is available, or else for reporting they'll take some third party product, say Hyperion financial reporting they may use, or else they can use OBI, Oracle Business Intelligence. Okay, so there are many other tools also available, but if you want to develop within this application, that should be done by technical team.
Yeah, actually I'm working on OBIE.
Okay.
So that purpose I'm asking. Sometimes we are building the reports and
You are working on OBIE means OBIE doesn't comes as a part of this Oracle product, Oracle Financials. OBIE coming as an inbuilt product as a in within the Fusion, not in Oracle R12 Financials or not in Oracle R12. So in this case, client has to take the separate license. They have to just plug with our Oracle applications. That's how they can pull the data and they can perform the analytics, reporting. Without all, they can do it.
Okay.
That's how it works.
Okay. Thank you, Lakshmi.
Yeah. So any other questions from other participants, please? No questions, we can wind up for today. The tomorrow session will talk about how the complete end-to-end sales process works. So how that process gets started and where at what point of time it will end. In the same way, the procurement process till we make the payment to supplier. All these two cycles, procurement complete cycle end-to-end and sales end-to-end cycles, which will be connected with our finance and how it ends, where the process starts, where it ends. Related to sales end-to-end execution and procurement, purchasing end-to-end execution, we'll be discussing in the tomorrow session. So any questions from anyone, please? No questions, we can wind up for now. Any questions, please?
No for mine.
Yep. Okay, fine. Thank you.
No question.
Okay, no questions, fine. What about others?
Nothing.
We are fine.
Fine, great.
No question.
Okay, fine. And if you have any, just if you get any questions later anyway, we have further sessions to discuss.
Lakshman.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Good question. Are you taking the classes on Oracle Fusion as well?
Yeah, I'm just taking the classes.
Okay, so I'm from PeopleSoft background, so my plan is to get into Oracle Cloud ERP. So I just want to start with Oracle Financials first to understand what's inside. So I just want, from when this other session starting on Oracle Financials, so I want to attend both simultaneously.
Oracle Fusion, see, and stuff, if you want, see, when you have a plan of learning this too, first you can start with this R12. Then you will get a better understanding. When you do the Fusion, what normally we do is all the time we'll compare with this R12 only. So in R12, this is how we have in Fusion, this is how the name they changed. Okay, that's how we call the term we call here, this concept we call in R12 with this name. Now in Fusion, we have it this way. This is how all the time we'll compare. If you go with a parallel learning, again, it will be a little bit challenging.
Okay.
to understand and all. You so do you and with 1 month gap, you can start with that, start with the fusion. So that would be the best way of doing.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Awesome. Thank you.
Oh, well, anyway, we'll communicate with you whenever we have a batch and all. We'll be circulating the mail. But I suggest you to start after 1 month. Okay, from this date.
Okay. All right.
That's fine.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye.
Yeah. Thanks. Bye. Any other questions, please? Fine then. That's all for today. We'll connect tomorrow same time. Have a good day and good night. Thank you all.